Good afternoon, children. How are you all? Hope you are all doing your homework and you are reading your textbook. Okay, children. So that day we finished our lesson. We were discussing about the kind of diseases. Then we discussed about that what are the diseases means, any abnormality in our body. Okay. And how do we know that we are having any particular disease? It will show some signs which are known as symptoms. That also we have discussed that day. Okay. Then we were discussing about what the doctor will do before giving you the medicines. So doctor, what he will do? He will check your heartbeat with the stethoscope and he will check your pulse, and then we can do the blood test also. All these things are known as diagnosis. So the previous class we have learned about diseases, symptoms and diagnosis. Then we also have started about the various kind of diseases. See children, some diseases, they spread from one person to another. When you touch them or you drink water contaminated or you sneeze, in this way, it spreads from one person to another. So all those diseases which spread are called as communicable diseases. So we have discussed about the airborne diseases, means those diseases that spread through the air, like common cold and flu. Then we discussed about the waterborne diseases, which spreads when we drink contaminated water. Example, cholera. Okay, or the next category we discussed the vector-borne diseases. Vector-borne means either through the insect or the fly, like dengue, chikungunya. So today, once again, we will discuss about them. And then we will discuss what are the preventive measures we have to take. Okay. So this is the first category that we have discussed, the airborne diseases, means which is spread through the air. As you can see through this picture, cough, sneeze, common cold, flu, these are all the diseases which is spread through the air. See, even nowadays, which diseases there, some people are telling it may spread through the air also, so you have to put the mask. So these are the airborne diseases, common flu, cold. Then these are few diseases which are caused by drinking the polluted water. So some of the examples are cholera, typhoid, dysentery. So in all these diseases which is spread by drinking the contaminated or polluted water, the person may feel like vomiting and the loose motions and tiredness because all the water is lost from the body. So all these symptoms will come. So now these are the symptoms of these diseases, typhoid, dysentery, cholera. The person will feel very weak. There's a stomach pain, a vomiting and the loose motions all together. And there will be a loss of water from the body and the person will feel very weak. Then we have discussed about some of the diseases that spread through vector, which are called as the vector-borne diseases. So diseases which are caused by the biting of insect or through the house flies. So these are few of the names which are given there: malaria, dengue fever, chikungunya, yellow fever, West Nile virus, equine encephalitis. So all these diseases, they spread through the mosquitoes. So children, these all are the communicable disease. So we can prevent them. Okay, we can prevent them to spread from one person to another. And for that, we have to take few precautions. So what are those precautions? Suppose there is a disease which is spread through the air. So whenever you cough or when you sneeze, you should sneeze or cough like this, or you can put the handkerchief on your mouth. Okay. Or a tissue paper, and then after use you have to throw it in the dustbin. Then whenever you are going to the public place, children, you should wear the mask. Nowadays also it's compulsory. See, like this, you have to wear the mask because it prevents the disease that spread through the air. Then what are the precautions which we have to take? Those disease which is spread through the hands by touching means we have to wash our hands again and again. Like this coronavirus, COVID, everyone is saying it's spreading. It is spreading by touch. When you are touching any object and if the virus is there, then you will get that disease. So to get rid of it, you have to wash your hands regularly. Nowadays, especially, actually every time, but now this is a pandemic time. So you need to wash your hands regularly. If someone is coming from outside, like your parents, they are going outside, coming, then ask them to wash their hands. Even if you are at home also, children, you should frequently wash your hands with soap and water. Not just with water. Compulsory, you have to use the soap and water. And if the soap is not there, then you can use the sanitizer. Okay? So these are the precautions which you can take the disease which is spread through the touch. Then there are many diseases, as I told you, which are caused when we drink the polluted water. So for that, what you have to do? You have to drink the filtered water. So filtered water, that doesn't mean that you need a expensive one, RO or something like that. If you don't have, you can ask your mother to boil the water and then she can strain that water using a cloth. Okay, a cotton cloth she can use. She can strain that water after boiling. So by this method, we can prevent ourselves from the diseases that spread through water if we are drinking the polluted or the contaminated water. So you should drink the filtered water, or not, you can boil the water and then strain. So some diseases, you can take the vaccination also. There are many diseases whose vaccination is there. So you can take the vaccination, you can visit to your doctor, ask the card of those vaccinations. And if some are left, see, few of the vaccines, they were given when the child is very small, 1 year, 2 years. But still there are many vaccines which need to be taken at the age of 16, 18 also. So you should regularly check your health card which was given to you by your doctor and check whether all the vaccines were given to you or not and which one is pending. So you can get vaccinated through vaccines and it can also prevent you from many diseases. Okay, children? So now it is a monsoon season. You need to take care of yourself. So what you can do? You should avoid water stagnation. Means don't allow the water to be stagnant at one place. Okay? Then use clean water. As I told you, boiling water. Wash your hands regularly. Then avoid pre-cut food. Don't cut the food previously and left over there and after a few hours you eat. No, because the flies and germs will sit on it. Then use antiseptic even for the mopping also. Boil the drinking water. Then clean before use every containers also and everything you should clean. No sweet food outside. Don't eat or drink anything from the outside. Okay, children? Then whatever dustbins are there in your home, you should cover them because from the dustbin also many germs will come. Then avoid dampness. Means you should try to dry your clothes in the sun. If not there, you can on the fan and then you can iron before wearing them. Okay? Don't stay wet. Suppose you are outside and you got wet, it started raining, you should come home and you should clean yourself immediately and change the clothes. So children, this was about the communicable diseases that spread from one person to another. But there are few diseases we do not spread from one person to another. Actually, they are caused when you are not eating properly something. And there is a deficiency of some vitamins in your body, some nutrients or some minerals in your body. Then you will get those diseases. So now we will discuss about some deficiency diseases. So look at it. Like if you are not taking proper vitamin A, then there will be a loss of vision. Means your eyesight will become weak, especially during the night time. You will not be able to see properly. Okay, so you have to eat a lot of beetroots and carrots for this. Then vitamin B1. Deficiency of vitamin B1 will cause the beriberi. What are the symptoms? Weak muscles and very little energy to work. You will always feel tired. You don't want to do any work. So this is beriberi. Then if you are not taking vitamin C, you will get scurvy. So what will happen in scurvy? Your gums will bleed. The blood will come out when you brush your teeth, that time especially. So for that, you have to drink a lot of citrus fruit you have to take. You can prepare the lemonade and drink it. So include citrus fruits in your diet. Then vitamin D. The disease name is rickets. Here the bones will become very soft and they will break very easily. So you have to, you can get vitamin C from the sunlight, okay? And also in the food also vitamin D is there. But every day compulsory you should stay in sunlight for 5-10 minutes. Then calcium, if you are not taking proper calcium, then your bones and tooth will decay. Okay, they will become very weak and they will decay. So you have to take a lot of calcium which you get from the milk. So every day you should drink milk, okay children? Then if there is a loss of iodine, then you will get the disease goiter. So in goiter, this neck region, there will be the swelling here in the neck region, okay? Then what you have to eat for this? Proper salt you have to take. In the salt, there is a lot of iodine. Then if there is a deficiency of iron, then the name of disease is anemia. In anemia also, there will be a loss of blood and you will feel a lot of weakness. Okay, children? And for iron, you have to take a lot of fruit, especially apple. It has a lot of iron. So every day if you take one apple, you will not get disease. That is why there's one proverb also, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. If you are eating one apple every day, if you are taking your milk properly, if you are taking all the fruits and vegetables, you will never become ill. Because all the vitamins and minerals, they are protecting us from several diseases. So all these diseases which I told you, okay, beriberi, scurvy, rickets, goiter, anemia, they are non-communicable diseases. Means they will not spread from one person to another. If you touch that person who is having goiter, it will not come to you. If you touch a person having anemia, it will not come to you. So they are non-communicable diseases. Few other non-communicable diseases are children, heart diseases. They will mainly occur in very elderly persons, okay, above 50 or 60. So they are having some heart diseases, low blood pressure or a high blood pressure. Okay, all these diseases are also non-communicable. Then there is one disease, diabetes also you have heard. So diabetes is also non-communicable. It will not spread from one person to another. Okay, children? So these are the few diseases which we have discussed. So we discussed about the communicable as well as non-communicable diseases. Then what are the precautions which you have to take to prevent yourself? And children, you should follow everything. If you eat properly and you follow all the instructions, you will never become ill. So all of you now read your textbook and then you have to write the definition of few of the diseases, communicable as well as non-communicable. And then I will going to give you some homework in your WhatsApp group. There you have to write the names of the 4 deficiency diseases. So all of you, now first of all, take out your textbook and start reading. Okay, children? Thank you and have a good day.